Palestinian issue is the longest issue or conflict in the Middle East. It's been going on for exactly 70 years, since 1948, when, with the help of the British colonialism, the Zionist organization succeeded to control about 70% of Palestine, historical Palestine, in which they drove the people, the inhabitants of Palestine out of the country to the neighboring and made them refugees till today. Took their homes, took their land, took everything they own. Israel continued to grow with the help of the American later on to become a very powerful country. It was financed from the Jewish lobbies, from the United States of America. And occupied again the second part of Palestine in 1967, which is the West Bank, Gaza Strip, and East Jerusalem. And that, the first thing is, they have violated the first resolution related to Palestine, which is the partition of Palestine, resolution 181, which called for two states, one for the Jewish and one for the Arabs. This resolution took place in November of 1947 at the United Nations. And it was clear, the resolution, that Israel will be accepted as a member of the United Nations if Israel accept the establishment of an Arab state. Israel became member but refused to recognize or to accept another state, which is for the Palestinians. So this was the first violation. So from the start, Israel, from the first day of its creation, violated the United Nations resolution. So acting above the law, it's been going on for the last 70 years by Israel, and breaking and breaching all the Security Council and United Nations resolution. Anyway, as a result, the Palestinians fought back by launching a revolution in 1965 and tried their best to liberate Palestine. But unfortunately, military-wise, we were not capable enough to run out a country which have the full support of the of America. Then we decided to sit and negotiate, because Israel always tried to convince the West and the world that the Palestinians wanted to throw us in the sea, want to destroy us, they don't want us to live in peace. So we had to make sure that what they are claiming is false, number one. Number two, we are a peaceful people, peace-loving people, and we have no objection of living side by side with Israel. We started negotiation from 1993 until a few years ago. We stopped negotiation because we found out that it was a waste of time and waste of resources, and they were bluffing all the time. They don't want peace, they don't want to give back the land which they occupied in 1967, they don't want to give any part of Palestine to the Palestinian people. It was very clear. Over that, well, in the middle, the international community, and especially Western Europe, start to realize the fact that it is true the Palestinians want peace and the Israeli doesn't want peace. Even the American from inside themselves, they know, they are sure that we want peace and they don't want, the Israeli doesn't want peace. Now, how to deal with this issue? We tried to involve other power, Russia, China, France, England, all powerful country that we can depend on, because we didn't want the United States of America to be the only mother of this process, because it is not a fair one. It's not a fair broker at all. It's siding Israel all the time, all the way. So we needed someone to side the, to be fair, not to be with us or against, to be fair. The latest move of Donald Trump recognizing Jerusalem as the capital of Israel has given us no choice but to deny them as a broker. We will not accept them as a broker. We will not do any negotiation through them or with their president. Now our policy is, if we want to negotiate with Israel, there must be an international body, including United Nations, Russia, China, France, England, all these countries, maybe all the five Security Council members, including UN, some other country who wants to participate, we have no objection, that they will be the broker. And then they have the right to put pressure to any side they feel that this side is not being fair. I was not shocked, but I was a little bit surprised to hear the last 3 days ago, the last announcement of Donald Trump, which he was wondering if Israel really wants to make peace. So that is a good sign, to start with a good sign. Now, I believe they know Israel doesn't want peace, but it seems to be no one from the American politician has the guts to say that directly, that Israel doesn't want peace. If we go back a little bit to Obama's time, John Kerry, his foreign secretary, in his last 40 days of his power, his place in office, he was very clear in his press conference, Israel does not want to make peace with the Palestinians. Settlement is jeopardizing the peace process. And they allow a resolution to be passed in December last year at the Security Council, the year before, sorry, that which says that, which talk about the settlement itself, that it is illegal settlement. And that's what we want to know, because all settlement is being built, it's inside our territory, inside occupied territory, which occupied in 1967. Now to know, 1967 is about only 6,200 square kilometer only. And the total Palestine historical is 27,000. So they will have around 21,000 of Palestine, 21,000 square kilometer. And we will only have 6,000. We accept that, but when we accept it, they refuse it. So it is very clear that with this government, Netanyahu's government, there is no way that we are able to reach an agreement with the Israeli. We and the international community support the two-state solution. Two-state solution came from America, actually, George Bush, he was the first to announce two-state solution, and accept that. We want to go for two-state solution. If we don't have the possibility or the chance, or we were not allowed to make the two-state solution as a final settlement, then we will go for one-state solution. This is Palestine, historical Palestine, name it whatever you want to name it, all the Palestinian people in Palestine and abroad have the right to come back and live in their homeland. And since you call it a democracy or a democratic country, let's go for election. Equal citizen, your faith is Jewish, mine is Christian, his is Muslim. It's okay, we live together as an equal citizen and we run the country. Obviously, they will refuse that. But finally, we don't have many choices. If no two-state solution, then fine, it's one-state solution. So the issue here, the environment around Israel is helping Israel a lot to continue its piracy, to continue its policy, to continue to act above the international law. First of all, no unity among the Muslim people. That's number one, real unity. There's no unity among the Arab states also. And who is backing us up as a Palestinian mainly? Arabs and Muslims. If the Arabs and Muslims themselves are busy in fighting each other, having lots of problems between each other, no unity, lots of disputes, then we have to turn to whom? Then we have to go to the West and to the Far East, because we need a supporter to support our cause. It's a just cause. Now, I just want to have 1 or 2 minutes about Jerusalem issue. The Jewish claim it is their city. Now, I will go back to the history. 5,000 years old city called Jerusalem. Okay? 5,000 years old called Jerusalem. Al-Aqsa Mosque was built 40 years after Al-Haram in Mecca. This mosque used to be the Qibla of the Muslim people, including Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. He prayed for 18 months to the direction of Jerusalem. There is a clear verse in the Quran, Subhanalladhi asra bi'abdihi laylan min al-masjid al-haram ila al-masjid al-aqsa alladhi barakna hawla. So, religious point of view. Now, historically, it is known to everybody that Palestine is called Canaan land, the land of the Canaanites. You have read the history, you should know that. And they are there 5,000 years before. When Prophet Ibrahim, alayhi salam, he came to Palestine, he came 1750 BC before Christ to Palestine. And their descent, his son Ishaq, okay, he is the father of the Jewish, right? So we were 3,000 years before him in Palestine. And Jerusalem, the name of Jerusalem, before Ibrahim came, we gave the name as Or Salim, because at that time we didn't speak Arabic, we speak Canaanese, and that was our language. Or Salim, Or means city, Salim means peace, the city of peace. We gave this name. Now, in the Old Testament, the same book that the Jewish believe in, it is mentioned that when Ibrahim came to the king of Jerusalem, Or Salim, the king of Or Salim, he gave him wine and bread and whatever, whatever. So that's proof that the name of Or Salim, it's been much longer before Judaism, much longer before the great grandfather of Judaism. So we were there when Ibrahim came. And that is the Old Testament says that and prove that we were there. So it is our land. How can they say it's our city? And I think it's the easiest thing is for them, it's just, you just say, God gave it to me. As they say, God gave it to us. Well, God is fair. He doesn't take from you and give to him. Okay, God gives from... Anyway, so this claim, historical claim, is false, because they are very good in falsifying the truth and the history, changing the history. They're good at it. But I mean, it is our history. And Jerusalem for us is the main issue. The main issue. Without Jerusalem, no peace, no stability, no security. We won't accept anything. If all Palestine is given to us and Jerusalem is not included, it's not acceptable. Because we'll not be betraying our people and our history and our heritage. We will be betraying our God and our religion and our prophet, in which we will not accept, we will not do. Jerusalem for us is the jewel of the crown. Without it, the crowns mean nothing. So Jerusalem is the only or the biggest motivation for the Palestinian people to continue to struggle. It's the biggest which motivate them to continue their struggle for generations to come. We hope and we are sure, definitely, no matter how difficult the Muslim world are going through, but people like you, people of Bangladesh, we have witnessed that for several years, how the people of Bangladesh sent volunteers to fight with our side by side with us against Israel, and they sacrificed their life for the sake of Palestine and the sake of Jerusalem. Your government fully support Palestinian cause all the time. Your government have no any kind of relation with Israel, which is another great support to us. And I believe that Palestine and Jerusalem and Al-Aqsa Mosque live inside each and every citizen of this country. We have friends in Indonesia, we have friends in Malaysia, we have friends in all the Muslim countries and the real supporters. And those are our assets today. So I thank you again for what you're doing. And what you're doing, it is big part and big support to our people and to our cause.